We think of these as zombie trees. When they're dying as a result of the blue stain fungus, we don't really know when they die, so they're kind of like the living dead. And we get to shoot them with shotguns. We can rapidly move all over the forest and take samples.
One of the big questions is what's happening to the water that was previously used by all of the trees that are dying or dead from the beetle outbreak.
There was an expectation that we might have at least a decade or two of extra water. Previous studies using fire and clear cutting as disturbance showed more water. What we actually found is that we don't see any difference in the amount of water in streams. We do see more water when what we call the stand. So where we're sitting today, there's more water in the soils, but we're not seeing that make it into the streams.
Half of the hardcore research here is U.S. Forest Service, but the other half is the University of Wyoming.
So one of the really exciting things about this collaboration is we actually are developing the tools across different disciplines to actually get at answers about where all that missing water is. Before, 2 years ago, I never would have imagined, as a geophysicist, working with a botanist and working with a river ecologist.
I sometimes think of it more like a posse, because it's a group of people who have a goal and we're just out there doggedly trying to get at that goal.
When we started back in 1999 measuring ecosystem fluxes here, our goal was to kind of capture the exchange of carbon and water just in a subalpine forest. So we're watching the ecosystem as a whole breathe in and out water.
We had the geophysics crew out here doing a couple of geophysical surveys. One of them was a seismic refraction survey. What the seismic refraction gives us ultimately is an image of the subsurface that can tell us what the maximum water carrying capacity underground is. And the other thing you saw was my postdoc Mehrez Al-Wasif actually recording tree res. When the wood is wet, it conducts electricity better, and where the wood is dry or drying, then it's going to be less electrically conductive. From that, we can track where the water is and where it's moving in the tree.
Yeah, there's a lot of things. Yep. The posse doesn't want to leave anything behind. At this point, we only have hypotheses for why the waters, we're not seeing it in the streams.
I think we have a really good chance at success with this and finding out those answers. I don't want to make it sound too easy, it's a challenge.
I think the main story about the water situation is that there's not going to be much change. And also, the forest is recovering faster than we thought, and so ultimately we don't expect to see much change into the future.
But it's been really good to work with the Medicine Bow National Forest. It's an adventure. It takes all of us to make the story work.